welcome to Hedgehog Hollow. I hope you're having a great day. I was kind of going to do this as a 2-minute tip, but I'm not sure this is going to fit into our 2-minute/4-minute window that we sometimes do. Greg's shaking his head behind the camera. But what I wanted to do is follow a couple of you who commented on our kind of my favorite things slash gift guides before Christmas. And some of you asked me if I was starting out again, what things would I put on my desk? And over Christmas, we shut down the hollow and I crafted lots and lots and lots of samples for Creativation. And so I had to kind of really narrow down the things I could fit on my desk. And Hannah and I were both crafting here. So I created this little cup of tools. And these were the things that I kept in front of me all of the time. Now I do have two thimbles that are just to the side of me over here. And they're full of all the things I keep on my desk all the time, but I found I wasn't reaching for those all the time. I was reaching for everything in my cup and all of these other items here. So I thought I would take you through these because these are things clearly that I use all the time and things that I really, really love. Now there is one tool I've had to put away because I can't show you yet because it's not released until Creativation. And I can't wait to show them to you because they're fantastic. You get two of them in a pack. And yes, I'm kind of teasing you a little bit, but you'll get to see them in about a week's time. However, what do I keep in front of me? Well, there's my Tim Holtz trimmer. There's no secret, I love this trimmer. It's a really nice size here. You can see kind of a reference to my hands, but you can cut 8.5 by 11 cardstock in this. And I did a 2-minute tip, check that top right hand corner for it. And something that one of the viewers came across, which was a really great tip, is if you put your cardstock along this bottom guide and then you cut, it has nowhere for it to go. And so it cuts even better than it was cutting before. So there's an extra top tip from one of our viewer comments in there. I also love my score buddy and I like the smaller size. This is perfect for me. I don't find I need anything bigger. It scores up to the 6-inch mark so I can do my 6x6 square cards in this. So that's perfect for me. So it's another thing I have here. I also have my Gemini Junior. I do have a full size Gemini as well. It's actually currently on the floor to the side of my desk because I've been cutting some larger tonic boxes and things. But actually my Junior sits on my desk all the time and in general that is big enough. I just bring out my full-size Gemini when I need it. I have my coconut that stores my tidy towel in from Gina K. That permanently lives on my desk. I also have my Spellbinders magnet, and inside of here there's a little magnet. So when I'm using those little dies to cut things out, or when I'm cutting the tonic boxes that have all those inserts, I can just pop them on here and I don't have anything. What do I have that's magnetic? My tweezers will, you can see they just stick straight on there. And it's great when I'm die cutting because I can just stick things on there. Or if I'm snipping dies apart, they'll automatically stick on there and they're not all gonna go all over the place. So that always sits on my desk. Some of you also asked about this. This was an eBay find. It's a Hello Kitty baby wipe holder. I love Hello Kitty, so I love this. And Huggies and Pampers and all of those baby wipes fit in here perfectly, as do these stamp cleaning wipes if you like those. But it's refillable, there's a little tab here on the bottom and I can just refill it with some wipes. So she sits on my desk all the time and she just makes me smile. So that's my Hello Kitty if you see her. This is an IKEA box and in here, I've had this for a long time. I've put this in lots and lots of videos. This is a holder that holds my Q-tips and it normally also has some of the micro brushes in it. There's a couple in my cup at the moment. These I use all the time as well. And I just pop those in there. I'll put another link in that top right hand corner right now to that video all about micro brushes and why they're so amazing. I keep a couple of light mist bottles in here, one with alcohol, one with water. There's a glitter duster in here. I have dropper bottles in here, one with water, one with isopropyl alcohol. And then I also have one that's currently empty, but I have one normally with alcohol blending solution in it. And then at the back, I have three of the Brutus Monroe Squeaky Clean bottles in here. One with Nouveau Stamp Cleaner, one with isopropyl alcohol, and one with water in as well. And these are great because you just press the top like this, your water comes in the top, and then you can either pick it up with a paper towel or your paintbrush or whatever you need. And then also my phone sits in here. And these are great because they stack together And I have lots and lots of these that we use all around the house and the craft room. And then this is my little toolbox of goodies. So lots and lots of things in here. So I'll empty it out as we go. So I have all of my Tim Holtz scissors in here. I normally also have a large pair as well, but they got put to the side. I have my craft spoon. I have, that's my craft pick, and this one's my craft knife. I have a quilting ruler that's the perfect size for card making. I also have my Brutus Monroe card making ruler in here. My Deluxe Adhesive stays in here. These are my Ginga ribbon scissors that are super sharp. I keep a Nouveau water brush in here, my surface sweep, my palette knife. I love these tweezers. These are Tula Pink Swiss tweezers. And the reason I love them is they've got this lovely point on the front here, which is great for working with sequins and gems and things on there. It's also really nice when you're trying to get sticky and things off. So they're super sharp, and I just love that kind of oil design on them as well. We'll make sure all of these links are there for you. I always keep some extra brushes in here, my really inexpensive Teflon bone folder, my beautiful LaurDIY wire clippers, and then there's also a micro brush in here. My crystal Katana stays in my top drawer because it doesn't actually fit in my pretty mug, but it sits in my top drawer with all of my basics and things in. We have just filmed a studio tour over Christmas. We've just got to edit it all together. It's actually loads of little different pockets to this room and storage and things, so it's taking us a little bit of time to put it together, but it will be a fab video when it's done. So that will be available soon, and you'll get to see all the different drawers and things we have around the room and how we have it all organized. But I thought I would just do a quick overview of my essentials, that if you were looking for things for your desktop or just to answer some of the questions of things like my Hello Kitty and that, we would stop by. How close was I to 2 minutes, Greg?
You're coming up 7.
Oh, well. That's a 7 minute essentials. There we go, 7 minute essentials video. So that's what I keep on my desktop. All the links are in the video description below for the things I've shown you. As always, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell, because we'll be off to Creativation in the next couple of days, and we'll have lots and lots of videos for you. As the official media partner, we will be on the show floor first. We will upload videos as quickly as we can. We're gonna have tons and tons of content for you. We will be with all of your favorite companies, all of those new releases, and lots of behind the scenes content as well. So don't forget to check all of those things out. We are super excited to share it with you. And don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you enjoy seeing what I use on a daily basis. We'll see you again very soon. Happy stamping, everyone. Bye.